Really, really, I will show you what is the basic of electronics because I am making the videos too much. But I am thinking to make that. But now, what is electronics and which components work, and what is our basic in components to, and what is the basic electronics first. Now, yes, you can see the first capacitors. Capacitor is what? Can capacitor is used for store the charge and stable the charge, which means when voltage is up and down, fluctuating, so it is then charge the voltage, and until voltage is rise down, it is discharge same time. So charge and discharge, meaning voltage stabilize. Because when the capacitor charge store and voltage is go downward, AC sine wave and sine wave go upward, the capacitor and store the voltage. When sine wave go downward, cycle go downward, it can discharge them and then maintain the cycle, not go up and down. So that's need a capacitor to stable the voltage. There are two types of capacitors: non-polar, polar. Polar for DC supply and non-polar from AC supply. So AC power supply, no priority matter, you can use idle on either way to connect them. But there's a polarized capacitor, when you connect wrong way, it is blast out and kill your circuit. So that's need to smooth voltage need a capacitors. All capacitor kind of work same, but non-electric DC for polarized for AC or AC and DC capacitor, electric capacitor for DC. And next inductors are coil which can induct the more voltage, which means when you flow the voltage, inductors use series. When you pass the voltage from the inductor coil, and it can generate a strong field. When you touch it, you receive nasty shock. So it means it's inductance to use. I mean, voltage power is boosted by this inductor. And next thing is resistance. Resistor, four types of resistance. Fixed resistance, fixed carbon resistor, which can a carbon resistor with fixed value. We can use a numbers turbines of the resistors to find a value. Another one is variable. You can adjust if you are variable resistors, it is can adjust 1 to 32 ohms. But I have 1 to 32 ohms, this is a 1 to 1 mega ohm resistance. So you can use any kind of resistance to adjust. So it is adjustable resistor. You can use single resistance other product. And it's a wire wound resistor. This resistance is a wire wound carbon material which wire and nitrogen wire which is also resistance. So what is a resistance? Resistor is used to limit the current. So the resistor is used to limit the current. Sometimes you need a high voltage, low current, you need a resistance cross high voltage supply, high current supply to limit the current, but voltage is still constant. So these all resistors work the same. So if a PTC or NTC, negative temperature coefficient or positive temperature coefficient, is a temperature sensor. When you eat it, you can eat PTC, positive temperature coefficient, it can increase the resistance. When you eat a NTC temperature coefficient, it can decrease the resistance. So both way, PTC is increase the resistance when you eat, and when you eat NTC, it is a reduce them. So that's it worth. After it's a relay a switch, mechanical switch, which can take a 12 volt for running DC worth AC or DC both. It is then consistence of one inductor. When you pass the voltage to inductor, this inductor is connecting parallel. So you can on then there is electromagnetic ties. So this pin is automatically pulled to upward. So which means these two pins bridge together and voltage pass this to this pin. And normal position, when position is this relay turn off, no power supply, these two pins are always joined touching to the other. When relay is on, it is bring this pin to upward to turn on up switch and down switch is turn off, which means this pin you can get a power input, and which means one bulb light there and one bulb light there. When you on a relay, this bulb is automatically turn off and this bulb is automatically turn on. When relay is off, coil is off, it is turned back down. So same thing is there, relay can work AC or DC with input DC voltage. So relay inverting voltage is DC. Relay can control switch AC voltage appliance, all DC. But this is relay can take a 12 volt for running voltage and appliance voltage 1 to 10 amperes. But we can after work same, but after 10 volt in DC. So it is take a DC voltage, also switch control a DC appliance with less current and less voltage. So this will contain LED and photoresistor. When light voltage is dipped to 5, this can work, photodoppler is worth a less voltage like a millivolt. When you dip millivolt to 5, 1 volt, when you dip a millivolt signal like there, it is bridge this ammeter and collector pin, so it can flow voltage ammeter to collector. So this is NPN photodoppler, which means negative flow ammeter to collector. When you use PNP, it is reverse. So meaning positive flow to collector, ammeter to collector. So PNP means input positive, output positive, signal negative. Or NPN means positive, input negative and output negative. So there's and after diodes. Diode is as a one-way valve, I already tell. Many time of diodes. So diode work, basically normal diodes work when voltage pass one positive voltage, electron flow one side to other side and negative electron flow other side to back side. But never flow negative electron to back, front to back and never positive electron flow back to left front. Because it is otherwise, if it's reverse polarity, it can block the voltage. So it is used to inverter when you cannot charge a battery. To do that, the battery can inverter to wrong way, it is your battery is blast. So this is a connector resistor. Diode in series your power line with when your power connect is prone is connecting, probe is connecting wrong to battery, it can cut off the your power. Battery cannot do the voltage dip to inverter. That's why your battery or inverter is not blast out. So it is a protect with reverse polarity. Use in series. General diode is same work, but general diode is little bit leakage voltage, which means when you connect a reverse, general diode pass a voltage with little bit voltage. This diode cannot pass voltage when you connect reverse. This diode you can connect reverse, it is pass voltage, but direct polarity voltage is more higher and reverse polarity voltage is little bit, because according to general diode, it is used parallel with circuit with series with a turn limited resistor 1 kilo ohm to take different voltages to different output, which means if you have 12 volt input and then they were 12 volt negative this side and 12 volt positive this side with series with the resistor. What happened, your general diode is drop down your 6 voltage with positive line to negative line and remaining 6 voltage you need to up these 2 points which are measured with multimeter. So it's basically what when you give a input general diode, double the voltage input to general diode, 12 voltage. This is the 3 volt, you know, you can put 6 volt, it can drop the 3 voltage by passing to the ground and 3 volt, extra 3 volt we can receive with by multimeter. And this is used for supply, for step down using. And lastly, PNP junction diode. So it is basically consisted of 2 normal diodes with thermal cathode pin. Common cathode pin. So you can leave positive this way, positive flow in center. Now if the positive this way, it is also terminated in the center. If you leave positive into center, positive cannot pass anyway. So if you leave negative to center pin, it is though both the direction is. And this is a fuse. It is used for over short circuit protections. For it is used as electronics device in series to protect short circuit and any damage. It is basically a ceramic body which is contain a little thin wire which is bridged to the electrodes. When short circuit, this bridge the wire is burned out. It is not damage your device. That when track and relay work is same. Relay work needing a DC signal, DC voltage to run relay and relay control AC appliance or DC appliance. That is controlled this only AC appliance by inputting a DC signal only. So that is basically consisted of two N, and one NP and one PNP transistor, but in parallel voltage and flow both ways. So that's why when you put in a signal into that, they can either 1 to 12 volts, and you can put this with your AC load in series to bridge your AC load turn on and off any kind of load, according to your load voltage and your power city power line or your trash power, and to you know otherwise it is burnt or damaged. So other are transistors. Transistor is basically a type of trapped bipolar transistors, but there are work in DC signal to DC switching. So basically it works DC signal into AC voltages, which means DC, it works with DC voltage to control an AC volt circuit, and this works to DC voltage to control an AC or DC both circuits. This control only DC circuit to DC. So there are this purpose of this transistor. When you apply a little bit signal for microprocessor or computer, your microcontroller unit system, it can give a small signal to bridge your heavy load. So this is a bipolar transistors, NP and PNP. When you NPN and PNP is difference between when you give NPN emitter is you give a negative signal, it flows to collector when base is activated with positive. Same as this, when you give a positive signal to PNP emitter, base give negative signal, and emitter negative positive voltage, and collector for load and base for positive signal, negative signal. So basically I tell you PNP mean input positive and output positive with reference signal is negative. So NPN is an input or output is negative voltage by applying a positive signal into base. Both are worth same, but this then what negative switching and circuit, and this is a positive switching circuit. PNP is used. Same as MOSFET. Now tell MOSFET. MOSFET is same thing. So P-channel MOSFET mean NPN transistor. P-channel MOSFET acts like the P and PNP transistor. PNP transistor. But there is a difference because NPN transistor, bipolar transistor, when you give a signal to base, your load is activated. But you can, if you give a signal, talk about the MOSFET, you can give a signal to base, it automatically energizes. After you can remove the signal wire, it automatically turn on your load. But you know to discharge this MOSFET gate by pulling this MOSFET gate with resistor to source, or either you can touch this pin at same time, it is turn off your appliance. But it, when you give a transistor voltage to this normal transistor base signal, it is not energized. So when your base signal is activated, your load is activated. Base signal is turned off, load is turned off. But this, when you little bit touch the base signal to a signal to the this MOSFET, these MOSFET gates, it can turn up voltage. After you can close the gate signal, it is automatically working by you can discharge it. So same as NPN or MOSFET, is all the working principles same, but there are difference in these two difference. It is charged, MOSFET is automatically charged, store the dead signal when you apply only minor signal into it. MOSFET and BGI transistor does not store any kind of signal and energize it. Transformer. They have a transformer. Their symbol look like this. So it is a primary winding, secondary winding. Primary or secondary is not both joined together. That happens in supply in, it is step up or step up down. When apply input primary winding to primary voltage according to transformer, it can act like electromagnet, which electromagnetic field plus by iron core. It is also comes with iron and ferrite core. My and it is iron core. So core is charged, when discharged by this coil, and this coil also generates electric magnetic field to electric field, which is step down or step up accordingly. If you give a step up, you can give a same thing, input voltage, low voltage to primary side and secondary side, you need high voltage or if you use the step down primary side high voltage and two secondary side low voltage. Symbol is first bridge rectifier symbol. There is a consistent of N and NPN junction diode and PNP junction diode. It means when this is comes live thermal downward and this comes neutral automatically it's thumb up. If this term is neutral, so there are a board is one, board is upward, I mean downward, and board is zero, board is upward. So this is convert AC to DC. So AC polarity is live neutral, DC polarity is positive negative. So when live is low, pass this diode, it involves live to positive. When neutral pass this diode to upward, it starts and live neutral to negative. And this now those practically. It is an inductor. Now all we need to check our inductor. Inductor is you can set a multimeter into continuity mode. So although this way you cannot check how much your inductors of the inductor, but you can check your inductor is fine or not. When I can touch it, so you can see multimeter is beeping, which means it is fine. Otherwise it is burn, it is not beep it. Or it's beat, if inductor is beat, so it can see any kind of resistance. So it cannot see any resistance right now. Now remove. Now same way to check this inductor is. So this is a 4-pin, not a transformative inductor. So you can see it is weak, little bit weak inductor, so you can see it is a 4 ohms showing. Our inductor is 45 inductor. Now I place right here. Now use the resistance test. First, all we need to do set in resistance. Although my multimeter is manual multimeter, so it is no adjust any ratio. It is fixed 200 kilo ohm resistance. Then measure 1 to 2 kilo ohm. Although you cannot touch now these two wires at a time. Exposed wire, it is can read your body resistance. Sometimes people can touch these two wires, exposed wire, to measure the resistance. It is not measure the resistance, it measure your body resistance. So you can see it is very sensitive. When I touch it, it is in my body resistance, which is 36 kilo ohm right now. Never touch it. Now you can see, I am connecting this wire. So you can see 80 ohms. 190 ohms wire slip. So you can see it is a 190 ohms resistance. Now measure other resistance. This is a variable resistance. So all we need to know, just that there are 3 pins. My resistance is a double resistance, variable resistance, so it is a double potentiometer. So it is a 6 pins, otherwise it is a 3 pins. Now wiper pin. What is a wiper pin? I am sure afterwards image you can see in image. So you can see the middle pin is for the wiper pin and left and right pins for the internal carbon film resistance. Carbon film. When I one wire carbon, I mean wiper. There is no metal quality, you can use any ways. So you can see when I accelerate, all wires slip. So you can see it is accelerate this wire. When I accelerate, let's see. So you can see I am accelerate this. This is it increasing or decreasing. So you can see. Resistor are increasing and decreasing. Although I am use one wire to touching, not two other wire touching. Oops, my wires fall out. Now I'm using alligator clips because my hand is slipping these wires. So now you can see it is 5 kilo ohms, 16 kilo ohms. When I then it accelerate, then it can generate a resistance up and down. So 16 kilo, 100 kilo. So all of this wire is not properly connected, so that's why it is fall up and down, but it is not clearly balanced. So that's where you can work this resistance, wireless resistance. It is a variable resistor. You can use this single resistance for your thousands of projects. Now those other resistance. Wire wound. Although this time I think in this wire wound resistor cannot measure by this multimeter, because this is a wire wound resistor, it is not measured at all. So you can see this wire wound resistor is not measured by this multimeter, but it is possible to measure the multimeter, but it is this type of multimeter that cannot measure easily. This one. Now change other resistance. Before doing resistance, now I'm showing a fuse first. Set continuity. Fuses look like this. Many types of fuse. This is a fuse. So when now it's no matter. You can touch it anywhere. There's no your body resistance capture it. So you can see now continuity, no resistance at my body. So when we shot in it, we can see it is beeping. If you see a hearing a beeping noise, it means your fuse is okay. Otherwise, it be no beeping sound and no display. It means your fuse are burned. Now those check are diodes. Basically, this is a normal diode. Basically, you can see there are diode, a line, but it is a old, little bit old diode, so it is, this line is removed. So when see, now I'm see, you can see this red wire in here, it is a positive wire, so it is not my yellow wire. When I connect yellow for this black side and this is a white side, this pin is in white side like there. You can see, not see, but it is a very dull white band. When I use that negative the multimeter connect this white band side and positive side connecting to this black side I think mean. So it sees a resistance. All it is continuity see, which means it is a pass the voltage. When you connect reverse, this time no voltage is passed. If voltage is passed, which means if diode is short or burned, so you can see no voltage pass. Now if though little bit change, for example this zener diode, this thing is little bit changed, because this time when you connect a flat polarity like this way, positive to positive and negative to negative. Hopefully it is positive. Yes, it's positive. So you can see it is like, I think black side is this is reverse. Black side is positive. So you can see it is a resistance flow. When that is reverse, I mean that this black side is positive, it's to meter positive, and that for negative, and this side is negative. So it, in this test, voltage is low. When you connect reverse, it is also flow the voltage, but voltage is too lower than now. So that test, meter cannot read at all, because meter can measure a minimum one. So this zener is 0.5 volt. And now the other one. I think zener diode is this way. And this is the same zener diode. It is a 12 volt zener diode. There is a tiny band that, so although these are too old, I mean not old, it is a little bit dull, this band is, so that's why it is not see. Now I remove the power supply once, multimeter set in continuity. Continuity means, when you continuity is bit thin, wire or fall, definite wire. When you set continuity, what do you do? Just touching it, so it is beeping. Although now my polarity is changed, so red bean is positive and black, yellow bean is negative. Now I connect this way, can see it is a ton of voltage. So this means this is the black side, and this is a black side, white side, and this is a black side. So when I reverse it, voltage is slow, but too slow. It is cannot read by my multimeter. So that's it. Now the other one. Lastly, left LED diode. What is LED diode? It is a light emitting diode. I have a RGB LED light emitting diode. So this is, you can see this LED intensity of two LEDs are more than. You can see these are two LEDs internally, two flats. Big flat is indicating negative and small flat is positive. So small flat is positive, which is will be connected to this red wire, which is connected to my multimeter in continuity mode, and otherwise automatically negative. And see, it is flashing and touch engine. With this touch engine RGB LED, lots of type of LEDs. Some are 4 pins, 1 pin for thermal anode and thermal cathode, according to LED, and other 4 pins for red, blue, green. But this is on build one LED. So it is 10. There are only one package, all LED plus one chip, which chip can indicate one by one LED simultaneously turn on and off simultaneously at 11 constant frequency. Now those other one. Now some relay. Basically relay has 5 pins. There's SPDT relay, which means single pole double throw relay. Some double pole double throw. It is when you can touch it, normally this point is Thurman point. One anyone wire that Thurman multimeter of continuity. Otherwise you can touch it, you can see normally close point. It is these two points are based to the other. Just I can see light here. These two pins are always joined to the other when relay is off mode. When if relay turn on, this switch automatically turn this way. So now I need a 12 volt. So because this is 12 volt relay, setting to 12 volt, 12.4. Let me wait. Just 12.2 volt. So relay are also no priority. So you can use any two wire, positive and negative wire, that normally open on normal close. So when I connected it, you can see multimeter is no display, which means relay is activated. Now it is though back to the normal position. If I connect right there, normally open points, which is not see no any kind of continuity. When I connect relay is on, continuity is on. This means we connect one bulb right there and one bulb is right there, and this is the input power supply. When we relay is on, one bulb is automatically turned off and automatically another bulb is turned on. When the power is on, off, and first bulb is turned on, second bulb is automatically turned off. So it is two-way switch, solid switch. Now those but one thing I am called is this diode. It is also new continuity. Now it is a positive wire, you can do that in a middle pin. I mean 90 watt at middle pin. So it is NPN junction, which means side two pins are negative and positive, I mean, and center pin is negative. So it is when the positive, it is C output reading. It is not B pin because this L, this is a, I put out this diode for my old power supply, so it is little bit weak. So it is C. When if that reverse them, like meaning the cathode side to positive and anode side to negative, it is cannot pass any kind of voltage. Now those photodoppler. It is also a switch, but it is a less voltage switch. So relay and that can need high voltage to turn on, meaning 1 to 12 volt to turn on, and control 1 to 200 volt, 100 to 200 volt. AC or DC according to device component, which means relay for AC, DC both, and that for only AC. So now this 10 was with only 5 microvolts and control maximum 85 volt max. So this test, the ammeter is negative, so it is NPN. So yellow wire is connected there and red wire is connected there. But it is not see anything beeping because this is a turn off. If now I adjust this power supply into 3 volt, otherwise less than 3 volt, 2.2. Now you can see it is a dimple, very small dimple dot light there, which means this is pin number 1. Let me tighten it rewire again and after show wires all slip out. So and wire slipping. So you can see there was a tiny dimple on there, which means this dimple is anode pin. Pin number 1 is anode. Pin number 1 is positive. So if that the positive pin to this red wire, and now there is a negative wire. So you can see these clips are little bit. I use this clip for 2 times or though, so that's why it is little bit slippy. Now I'm return on the power supply because my power supply has best feature. If short circuit is, it is automatically turn off. So now slips are. So you can see when I increase the voltage, so you can see it is a continuity because relay need this upper ampere. Now you can see it is working. Now no other components. Remove everything. Now those the first those speaker best you connect any one wire to any one point. This way you can check a speaker or not, your speaker is fine or not. You can not check your how much percent your speaker is good or not, because this way you can check only speaker is fine. When speaker is fine, so you see any reading. So meaning this speaker as in also electromagnet contain a copper wire which is acts like an inductor. So when you can see this voltage flow, this inductor, when inductor is burned, it is show no inductance, no reading. When it is short circuit contained with speaker, it can beep. But if no beeping, no, it is 3 digits, which means it is OTE. Now check how much is OTE. Just plug into ohms. I'll do this. Peter did not say any resistance about this speaker, but most speakers are 3 ohms. In this test, this speaker is 1 ohm, which means this speaker is also too weak, because I do think this speaker for telephones of PTCL. Transistors first. There's a transistor. Same I'll be need to do connect continuity. Multimeter negative probe connected to ammeter. So base collector ammeter. There's an NPN configuration. So ammeter is that's one wire. So ammeter is negative. So it is NPN and base and collector is output for load. I mean positive. And now I take a battery. If that battery between ammeter also connect a battery, ammeter connected to battery negative as well as the multimeter negative as well as collector connected output and base connected to positive of the battery. So you can see when I connect it, multimeter is beeping. many times to our work. When I then remove, battery can turn off. So this way it's worth this VGI transistor. If you and PNP transistor, it is reverse because it is collector base emitter or emitter is, I mean base collector emitter is same, but this time emitter is positive and collector is negative. So it is a PNP, and this time base is also negative. Now I am that with base to this way. Base is signal negative. If the signal, I'm the battery acts like a signal source. Because transistor what? Voltage, not a signal. But microcontroller as send a voltage like a signal. Which mean when you need a signal, need to what? When you can command the by electrically command the command also known as signal. But the electrically is voltage. Now I'm tell, but not problem at all. Just flip this way. So you can see multimeter showing reading, which means it's what? When we try same thing with MOSFET, although I have only N channel MOSFET right now, not P channel, but I'm showing N channel, right? So this test. 3 pins, 1 pin is broken, not matter at all because this bad chassis central pin is. So, gate, drain source. Drain is positive, so which means drain is net right there. And source is net right there. I mean, this is a gate, source right. Let me check. Yes, like there. When I connect the battery to like this way, you can see it is beeping. When I remove the battery, it is continuously beep. Because this MOSFET is charged the voltage. When I touch my finger with these two wires, it can automatically turn off. Meaning this is a NPN, BGI or MOSFET is same, but little bit difference is MOSFET can collapse the internal signal. When if signal is removed, it automatically turn on. But when I shut into my body can discharge this. It is turned off automatically. Now I am set. Tell you a battery. Although my multimeter is not activated, so that's why I am not telling you like there. So you can see there's a DC voltage. Now check my battery. This time you need a priority, otherwise it is door on. So when I connect this negative to there and positive to, now you can see there are this 9 volt battery. When this battery is old, this is a 8 volt and this is a 14 volt, which means this is a 7 volt. It is a double the voltage because this my multimeter is too faulty at all. So this is DC mode more than AC mode. So make your alternative turn and DC turn. All the one thing I more tell you, this is a bridge rectifier. Because when you use this transformer to your AC supply as well as a charger, you need an output voltage, the output AC voltage. So you need to convert DC by just adding a full bridge rectifier. Full bridge rectifier symbol is look like a battery symbol is a full bridge rectifier symbol. There is a consistent of N and NPN junction diode and PNP junction diode. Which means when this is comes live it's tumbled downward and this comes neutral automatically it's come up. If this term it's come down and this term is come up. So there are a board is one, board is upward. I mean downward. And board is zero, board is upward. So this is convert AC to DC. So AC polarity is line neutral, DC polarity is positive negative. So when live is though pass this diode, it involves live to positive. When neutral pass this diode to upward, it is stalled and light neutral to negative. Home change and then this PTC to this wire multimeter. So no polarity matter. Now when you can see there is no topic, no resistance. When I heat it, resistance is rise up. So this is a PTC. If you use any NTC, it is reverse. PTC, when you use a PTC, PTC is increasing the resistance. When you use 10 use NTC. NTC is also resistance. When you then eat it, it is this resistance. So you can see all of my wires burn, but it might be not the idea at all, but I'm sure you. So you can see it works. Now I remove the wires. Although this PTC is too hot, maybe my hand is burned. Oops, it's too hot. At this point, I am asked you, it is not a good idea because it's too hot. It is might burn my hand on my table. I think never eat this way to match it. And now those other components. These are chips. What is a chip? These are chips. Chips are in the component which is create a lots of under components, tiny assembly components combined to make a single component. All of you that made a project, you need a lots of components. It is lots of expensive and lots of effort. You need a small tiny component like this chips to you can make your work and tossed less tossed and what easy less effort to make your project, because this IC is contained, it is not a component. It is a circuit board. It looks like a circuit board, tiny micro-sized circuit board with tiny amounts of components. You cannot see these components with normal your eyes, but you can see a data sheet, www.datasheet.com, to check a part number to see that this IC contains thousands of millions of components combined to make these tiny logic ICs. This one IC can work only both one or two. If you can use lots of projects, you can use according the number of the IC to data sheet to check which IC worth which IC worth is which. So you can know, you can use a few one IC and what a few or five one type of projects and other project you need other IC. One main IC, one thing is one new type of IC which IC start microcontroller. We can use a single IC microcontroller to your all kind of project. So you can not need any more ICs to make your project. You can use just one microcontroller to use to make your project. You can program your microcontroller is as IC, but this is a programmable IC. You can let with team with a microcontroller development board. You can put the microcontroller into development board, development mode to your PC, and easily to program and software to software and use as any kind of project this. But this is not a microcontroller, this is a normal IC. It is a tiny IC with tiny components, thousands, millions components combined to them to make this tiny IC is. This is amplifier IC, this is a communication IC, and this is opto-doppler IC, photo-doppler IC. Lots of IC is lots of numbers. You can see numbers are IC in internet with datasheet. If you cannot see at datasheet.com, you can see the part number of the Doodle, this component part number, you type Doodle and type part name. IC, if you can find IC name, you can find IC. If you find a transistor, you can find a transistor name. If you use a rectifier, you can use rectifier one. And that's where you can find these things. So there's IC is lots of components combined. So it is a, this when you know your when you use a bigger computers, you know now technology reaches bigger, more and more upgrade. So your laptop PC system was laptop, so it is compress them bigger PC into small laptop. So that's why this first time this IC is not available. So you use tons of components to make a project. So it is not easiest. Now this IC can work very easy. Now one thing I may tell you. These are a relay. Relay you can use is this side you can give DC voltage and you can use this control switching by AC or DC voltage. Relay can handle up to 500 volts with or 200 volts according to relay. So relay what AC DC relay can use for AC DC voltages. Relay working voltage is AC. So DC I mean. Relay need to what
with DC voltage and relay can switch in AC voltage, AC or DC. But same thing, this triad is both DC voltage but is controlled AC volt, not a DC. Which means we then need an input signal is DC signal to switch AC 220 volt bulb or either 12 volt, 5 volt, 10 volt AC bulb. Relay can use AC bulb or DC bulb to turn on and off by relay. Relay need only DC signal. How it is that works and how that is worked by demonstrate in next video. So NPN or PNP transistor is any package. This package on this is a 220 package, or other package is 210 package, and this package metal case and may is contain IC package. So this may MOSFET and transistor comes with these package 220, 210, and this metal case package and this IC package is. So you can see all data sheet, and I am telling. So this is a neon LED. It is symbol as a normal, not as a normal LED. It is a symbol as like a bulb. Bulb symbol you can see in my previous video. I uploaded, I also put a link in description. So you can see I put. Now this way I'm telling how you identify transformer primary secondary. So I am taking up any one winding connecting one pole is to power supply 16 volt or other point is touching with negative terminal, and other you can see this LED is working, which means this is a primary side. If I connect reverse, so reverse all my terminals is short, remove these terminals. If then turn on this, you turn on first light. So this first light has short circuit protection. So may anything wrong, it can cut off power instead of burning everything. So this feature is very good feature. So this feature is activated when everything is on. If you then see, now I'm shorting this wire, no LED is on, which means this is a primary side and this is a secondary side. This way you can see and identify with your primary or secondary secondary. So secondary side is high voltage side. So you can connect LED with secondary side and primary side to turn on. I'm secondary side turn on, primary side is LED lit. If not LED is secondary side, primary side is powered, if it is not on at all. With all this step down transformer, if you use reverse it, you use as a step up. This way you can identify. Now those are PTC temperature coefficient. Neon, all the one thing I more tell you, if a neon LED indicator, it's what maximum, it is not LED on, it is not bulb, it is what with maximum 80 volt, minimum to 60 volt, otherwise it is not work at all. So it is used switch with limited resistance or unlimited resistance to use an indicator of switch. Pinouts and anything with VGA pins, USB pins, other kinds of pins are available in electrodiode, and I am using 80 ICs for 80 ML for microcontroller and PIC data sheet database. These two softwares to use chips, and I am also using Tesla coil or inductor transformer calculation software, and I am also using Pinterest with the electronic circuits. Alright, so this is a lot of interesting things on Pinterest, like electronics and chemistry related also. Wait, I am using data sheets, and I am also use datasheet.com. I am also use this is a website. I am also use S manual, which means service manual, data.com, which is also a website. So there's a new interdated circuit. I mean, this is a what is inside this appliance and what is inside other plants. So all we but inside of the appliance circuit is available in the S manual, service manual. Pause.